In today's video, I'm going to be fixing the most unlucky football team in the world.
I like it!
Now, we're going to have to base unlucky on something because it's a very subjective term. I think basing it on how many Champions League finals a club has lost, that could be smart.
That makes sense.
We're going to take the help of Google for this. Which club has lost the most Champions League finals? I think I know who it's going to be. Who? Juventus. They've been runners-up the most times, losing 7 finals. After that, there is 3 as the next club. Oh my god, losing 7 finals. Well, we're fixing Juve.
Challenge accepted.
Here we go, let the fixing begin. And to be honest, I think they do need a bit of fixing.
Boom. Roasted.
First of all, Paulo Dybala is going to be leaving, so we're going to make that happen in this challenge. And also, after years of dominance, they're out here finishing 4th in the league, so they're a club that desperately need fixing. A big thank you to Gate.io for sponsoring this video and the channel for this month. Gate.io is a safe and reliable place to buy and sell your crypto. It's also their 9th anniversary. Make sure to check out the link in the description to sign up now. And also, you guys should check out their channel. They've got a great playlist for content about crypto to get yourself informed and educated, so I'd highly recommend that. Once again, a big thank you to Gate.io for sponsoring the channel. Links in the description. All right, guys, here's the Juventus team we're working with in this first season. I think, first of all, Paulo Dybala, the first offer we get for him, we're gonna let him leave. Apart from that, Vlahovic in the attack is very, very good. Then we've got players like Zakaria, who can probably grow pretty quickly. De Ligt's amazing, but then there are so many old players. It's not going to be easy replacing them all. By the way, where's Chiesa? He's going to be one of the most important players for us. Look at him. He's right here. I think straight away we need to sign Chiesa on a permanent deal. Like, honestly, that has to be the first transfer. But how much money are we working with Juve in this fixing challenge? 100 million plus. We should get a good amount of cash for, of course, the Paulo Dybala deal. But yeah, let's sign Chiesa right here, right now. We need to, man. We absolutely need to. This guy is the future of this Juve team. All right, let's see if we can get him for 67 million, and we can. Let's go. That's brilliant. There we go. Negotiating for Chiesa. Crucial squad role for him, of course. 5-year deal, if that'll work. Perfect. Come on now. No release loss. This sounds like a reasonable contract. He might ask for more money. No, he doesn't. We've just signed Chiesa on a permanent deal. Not bad. I think I definitely want to play a 4-3-3 with this side, because Chiesa needs to play. Basically, Vlahovic striker, Chiesa on the right. That's how we roll. I like that midfield with Arthur, Locatelli, and Rabiot, at least for now. We've got depth as well, McKenny and Zakaria. What we do need, guys, it's evident, it's a left winger. Absolutely. That's where this team is lacking so much right now. Guess we'll have to wait for getting a bit of cash. It all depends on how much money we can get for Paulo Dybala. And an offer's already come for Dybala. Arsenal are giving me Gabriel Martinelli for Paulo Dybala. Surely I can get more money for him. Let's delegate the offer and just try and get as much cash as possible, because cash is king.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. True.
Now we get an offer from Chelsea. They're giving me Jorginho. Are you joking? Like, just give me cash. I want cash for Dybala. Okay, Dybala sale agreement. They're willing to pay me 82 million. That is Arsenal. Okay, now that works for me. Is he going to move to London? I mean, yeah, if Chelsea sign him, he will also move to London. But let's see if Chelsea do end up signing him. Chelsea willing to pay 89 million. So it's basically Dybala's decision where he's going to go. Dybala's been sold, and he's been sold to Chelsea. He's chosen them instead of Arsenal. And I'm not surprised.
It's time to go.
And that leaves us with 117 million to improve this team. Let me see what we need, actually. Definitely a left winger. We probably also need, like, a right back. Yeah, because Cuadrado's gonna dip really hard in his overall. So let's focus on those couple of positions. I've been hearing about rumors about Memphis Depay joining Juventus. This could be an option, you know. I think he'd fit right in. Experience is, I think, what we need, because Chiesa and Vlahovic both are young players. He brings in that 85 overall. I like the idea of this. We'll convert him to a left winger. Probably a solid replacement for Dybala. All right, let's see how much we're going to have to pay for him. Barcelona in need of cash in real life as well. We'll give them that. 92 million. Are you joking? I can get so many better players for that. Oh, that is outrageous. Let's go in with 65 as our next offer. Finally, they're talking some sense. They've brought it down to 74. Surely we can get it down to, say, 69 million. Why not? And that works.
Nice.
You know what? An offer coming in for Bonucci, 21.2 million. It might be prudent to just negotiate and get the best fee possible. Because he's 34, man. If we don't sell him now, we're not getting anything for him. And we need to plan a future without Chiellini and De Ligt. Did I say De Ligt? Nah. De Ligt's part of this team forever. I meant Chiellini and Bonucci. In other news, we've managed to sign Memphis Depay. That's a pretty big signing, I'd say. Let us now convert Memphis Depay to a left winger. Because otherwise, we literally can't use him. Not gonna lie. I'm thinking I convert Zakaria to centre-back. I just feel he'll be more useful in that position. Well, let's see how this goes. I'm selling Bonucci for 26 million, man. Give me the cash. We've just sold Bonucci for about 26 mil. I like the idea of Ricardo Pereira at right back. Experienced in his prime. I think he can help us win the Champions League. So we're going to go for him for that right back role. Hopefully, he isn't going to cost an insane amount. We're going to start with 35 million as our first offer. And he is going to cost a fair bit. But we do need a good right back. And I think Ricardo Pereira is a solid option. We're bringing it down to about 51 million. Let's see if we can reduce it just a little bit more. 48 million works. This is key. An offer for Danilo. I think keeping Danilo is a bit better. If we can get Cuadrado sold, the extra cash could be used elsewhere. This is turning out to being a ridiculous window. It's so much happening. In other news, we've completed our third signing. Ricardo Pereira is here. Not gonna lie, I do like the team with Ricardo Pereira in there, with Memphis Depay as well. Chiesa now on a permanent deal. I think we've done well for this first season. Between all this transfer madness, we've got a final to play, the Supercoppa, Italian Super Cup. Can we win this? Yes, we can. New signing Memphis scoring the goal. We still have about 60 million to spend, and we can use that somewhere real nice. Where's the question? Maybe a midfielder? Yeah, I think that's where we're really lacking. Feel like I haven't used UDT elements in so long. I'm gonna see if a swap deal is possible between him and Adrian Rabiot. If so, that would be the dream. Let's see. 30 million is what Rabiot is worth. We'll chuck in another 30 million in the offer, and let's see what Leicester are willing to do. They are willing to work with us. This would be an absolutely brilliant deal for both parties, I'd say. Come on, let's try and pull this off. They still want that 52 million. We'll give them 46 and see what they say. Come on now, let's go. I don't think I've had this much fun getting through this window, because this Juventus team is broken. They've got so much money and we're able to change a lot of it. I think this is going to be our final signing for season one. We've literally improved almost every position. Tielemans comes in. I think we've had a solid window, boys. That's going to be our team for the first season. Don't expect to win the Champions League, but I want to see some solid player growth and maybe a fight for the title. So in the Champions League, first season, I think even though we've made so many changes to our team, we're not there yet to win the competition. But let's see if a miracle happens in the first season. We're second in our group. Round of 16, we're up against Man United. Yo, midway through the season, the team has grown a fair bit. Look at that. Zakaria already higher rated than Chiellini. We're putting him into the starting 11. I think I'm going to make De Ligt captain then. First leg, Juventus versus Manchester United. Let's see what happens. Come on. It's a 1-0 win. Vlahovic scoring. Classic Juventus. But Chiellini subbing on for Chiesa. I know they share the same four letters in their name at the start, but what? Second leg against Manchester United. Can we complete the job? We can. Chiesa and Arthur getting the goals. Come on now. What a finals. Oh, it's Atletico Madrid in the next round. This could be donezo for us this season. Atleti is not easy. Absolutely not easy to get through, but we do have a good team. It's a 0-0 draw. Typical. Atletico Juve being a 0-0 draw. All right, here we go. Atletico Madrid versus Juventus, and Tielemans out injured. Ah, for the second leg. This could mean curtains for us, and it does. Out of the Champions League in the quarters. As I said, this season expecting a Champions League. Too tough. We'll come back stronger next season. But we're still alive in other competitions. Do we end up winning the league and all? We need to find out. Oh, yes, we do win the league and by a massive margin. 15 points. Juventus are back to the usual dominance in the Serie A. Just time to make them stronger in Europe as well. We also win the Super Cup. Lovely. Pretty sure I mentioned that at the start. Ah, we don't win the Coppa Italia. That goes to Milan. So only the league and the Super Cup this season. Isn't too bad, you know, in the first season after Juventus' struggles without Paulo Dybala. I think we've done a good job and the team's looking nice. Not surprised. Oh, actually, I am surprised. Memphis Depay, top scorer, told you it'd be a good signing. Vlahovic with 14 goals, and look at Tielemans. What a transfer. Our signings have worked wonders, boys. Let's head into next season and build a better team. I think we're in a very good spot for season two. I look at this team. That attack is tremendous. The midfield with Tielemans, Arthur, and Locatelli. I like that too. The defense is where I think we could do with a bit of investment. I reckon we get a world-class left back. back and maybe a bit of depth for our attack, and we're good to go. Kulusevski coming back from his loan spell already helps us out with a bit of depth. We're coming for that Champions League this season. Last season was all about getting Juventus back on track, winning the Serie A. This time, I want to progress further in Europe. I think you guys know who I'm going for that left back position. It's a player who was at Juve a few years ago, but then Juventus just made the most weird swap deal ever, taking Danilo and giving Cancelo. Well, we're going to fix that. I'm going to sign João Cancelo for our left back spot. Now, this is going to be ridiculously expensive. I might have to try and get a deal by putting Alexandro and about 70 million. Is that going to even be accepted by City? They want Alexandro, but they also want 133 million. Are you kidding me? This much money for a left back? Absolutely unreal. Let's put in 90 million and see what Manchester City actually say. They still want 133. Yo, this is insane. We're spending 100 million on a left back. But hey, Cancelo's insane, and I think it's worth it. He's probably one of the best fullbacks in the world, if not the best. We're gonna keep upping our offer and just seeing where Man City decide to accept. And oh my god, they just want 133, you know. Let's go with 120 and see what Manchester City say. And finally, that works. I really was expecting to make like a few more signings in this window, but this has limited us. I think we can only make one more good signing after this now. So a bit of a challenging situation to be in, but I really wanted Cancelo. I think playing him at left back is what this team needs. There you go, Cancelo signed. I told you guys, Cancelo adds so much to that back line. We've got a Portuguese team in our fullbacks. Now, I think we're lacking a bit of depth in our striker department, so I'm going to sign Giacomo Raspadori. He's probably only going to be on the bench because we have Vlahovic, who's the main man up top, but still, a bit of depth in the bench can never be wrong. Let's start with 30 million for Raspadori. They want 45.6. You know what? Let's just get it out of the way. And there you have it, guys. That's our next signing done. I don't think we've got more money for any more signings, but the squad is certainly a lot better. Guys, I like the look of this team a lot. It is unreal. We've got a formidable attack, a great midfield, a great back line. Let's see how we fare this season. I'm expecting us to win the Champions League. First up, though, Super Cup against AC Milan. Why are they playing Gaia up top? Pretty sure that's Jose Gaia. It has to be. Anyways, let's sim this game and see what happens. We managed to win the Italian Super Cup 1-0. I still don't understand how they managed to play Jose Gaia at striker. Maybe that's a different player. You know what? I'm curious. I want to see who that player is. Gaia? It's surely not Jose Gaia. No way. He's at AC Milan. Yo, they just played Jose Gaia at striker against us. What?
Huh?
We managed to top our Champions League group with a perfect record. Let's go. Round of 16, we're up against Man City. Hey, it's a good thing we signed Cancelo off them. All right, first leg against Manchester City. They've got Diego Aspas playing for them. That's weird. And Alexandro against us. Wow. So that's a bit of a weird one. The first leg ends in a stalemate, a 1-1 draw. If we can knock out Man City, I think we're good enough to win the Champions League. Let's find out now. And we thrash them 4-2 in the second leg at home. Memphis, McKenny scoring, and Vlahovic with the crucial goals. Well, it's Villarreal up next for us in the Champions League. Let's not mess this up. We're up against Unai Emery's men. This should be a cakewalk, but De Ligt's injured. Okay, that's not good. And because of that, it's only a 2-2 draw. Was he injured or was he sent off? Not entirely sure. But the second leg now is going to be key. Yep, he was suspended, so he should be back for the second leg. Second leg against Villarreal. Let's see this one out. Come on, let's go. De Ligt's back, and we're back to business. Semi-finals now. Uh-oh, this is where things could go completely wrong. PSG in the semis. Honestly, if you look at our team's overalls, we're there. We can beat them, but we will need a lot of luck against the PSG side with Messi, Mbappe, Neymar, and we don't get that luck in the first leg. We lose 2-1. Well, they are the most unlucky club in football for a reason, because PSG in the semis, like, come on, man. Second leg, though, it's a 2-2 draw, but not enough. Not enough. We're gonna have to do another season with them. Can we win the cup, though? That would be a real nice thing after getting knocked out in the Champions League. Yes, we can. No way, guys. We lost Serie A as well this season by 3 points to Atalanta. That's bad. This has not been a good season. Player growth's been solid. I don't know what went wrong. Maybe we need a bit more improvements in certain departments, like the midfield, I guess. But we'll see next season. Vlahovic this time, top scorer. 30 goals this season. season. Look at Chiesa and Depay as well. Those stats by these two are insane. I think we should have won the Champions League last season. It's a shame we couldn't, but this season, let's make it happen. 231 million, just what we need. You really thought I was going to do this video without bringing Paul Pogba back to Juventus? Absolutely not. We're doing it right now. I think we need a bit of something extra, you could say, in midfield, and Pogba could just be the man for the job. And he shouldn't be that expensive because he's 30. Let's see. He might not be a starter because Arthur is just as good as him, but I think it's a player we need to improve squad depth. And there you have it. We've actually signed Paul Pogba for Juventus. For now, I guess Pogba gets into the team as a starter. We'll see how that develops. Where else can we improve? Maybe an upgrade for Zakaria or Ricardo Pereira? That's an option. But honestly, I want to try using Zakaria. Look at his stats. He's absolutely insane with 88 pace. Ricardo Pereira is a bit of a beast as well. I love the squad depth we have as well. You know what? I'm taking a chance this season. I trust in this squad to bring us the title. Let's do this. We topped our group once again, this time with Manchester United in it, and we're up against Leverkusen. Not gonna lie, with the team we've got, Leverkusen should not be a problem. Although we don't have Chiesa for the first leg, that's maybe caused a bit of a problem. 1-1. Second leg against Leverkusen, easy stuff. We knock them out. Oh my god, this sums it up. The reason why Juve are the most unlucky club ever. Once again, PSG in the quarters. But if we can knock them out, I think we can win the Champions League. So first leg needs to be a strong result. It's a 2-2 draw. I think we can do something now at home. At home against PSG. Yup, we're up against Messi, Mbappe, and Neymar. But it's good enough to get through. Memphis Depay in the 89th minute scoring the winner for us. Let's go. It is now Liverpool we face in the Champions League. No luck whatsoever. But can the old lady break the curse? Let's see. Here we go. First leg against Liverpool. We need to get at least a draw from this. Like, come on. First leg at Anfield. And it is a draw. Danilo, of all people, coming on and scoring a goal for us. Let's go. At home, in front of the home fans, surely we can knock out Liverpool. And on penalties, we do it. It's João Cancelo scoring the final one. And Mo Salah missed his. Let's go. Champions League final, boys. And it's Chelsea we're facing in the Champions League final. We can't lose this. 7 times Juve have taken L's in the Champions League final. Not again. We managed to win Serie A, though. Let's go. Are we on course for the treble? We managed to win the Coppa Italia. We could win a treble here. Yep, the team's looking insane with overalls. Our front three all 90+. Locatelli, 90. De Ligt, 92. Cancelo, 90. We're ready for this final. Who's our top scorer this season? Chiesa? Vlahovic with a slow season. I'm surprised with that. I'm really keen to using the likes of Vlahovic, Depay, players I normally don't use. Chiesa as well. Zakaria at the back's going to be interesting. And oh my god, this story has come full 360 back at us. Look at this. A full 180, as they say, actually. Dybala up against Juventus in this Champions League final against his former club. Couldn't have been any more poetic, but we're going to hand Chelsea an L here. Let's go. Okay, how have they opened up this much space? And where's our backline? Cancelo trying to do something, but it's Chesney who comes in with the save. Chelsea with a big chance early on. Uh-oh. Chelsea with another chance. It's Cunha turning and shooting. Zakaria does well, but they still have the ball. We're on the back foot in this game. Cunha turns me there. Cut back inside. Cancelo, what are you trying to do there? Guys, we're so lucky this worked out. Look at Cancelo in the box trying to clear the ball away like this. Has he lost his mind? We're so lucky that it didn't rebound off into a goal for Chelsea. Here we go, Memphis Depay. He's been in form in this game as he really moves the ball nicely towards the inside. I see Tielemans making a nice run. A cross back in for Vlahovic if he can get there. It's a good idea, just didn't work. Vlahovic. Oh, what a finish from Vlahovic. We get the opener in the Champions League final. And it's Vlahovic. Who else but him? 1-0 up against Chelsea. Arthur ended up becoming a starter for this team, but I do want to see Pogba in a bit of action. So we're going to bring on Paul Pogba for the rest of this game. Here he comes. Pogba back in a Juve shirt, although it's a Piemonte Calcio shirt, but yeah. Oh, here's Memphis again. Oh, that was nice. That was absolutely nice. Still Depay. Nah, I want to get a goal with Depay. He just feels so different on the ball to other strikers. Like, he's got that dribbling, but also a bit of strength. I'm feeling good vibes off this game, man. I feel we can break the curse, finally. We're looking good. Just got to keep our heads down. Now it's... Oh, Cunha, go on. No. Just as I was saying, we were looking good for winning this. Chelsea with a massive chance. I'm glad we didn't concede. What just happened? What just happened? Yo, what just happened? I think there was a handball somewhere and we're matted. There was no threat for a goal. Oh my God, I can't believe it. This explains it. Why Juventus is the most unlucky club in football. Unbelievable, man. That's been given us a penalty and now former Juve player Dybala to take this one against us. No, he's missed it. Oh my God, Dybala's missed it. We get a bit of luck finally. Paulo Dybala's put it wide. That's the worst penalty ever. Oh my God, I think he knew. He felt bad for his former teammates because that wasn't a pen. Yo, if we can score this with Mr. Memphis, things would be fun. Let's see, Memphis Depay, good power on it. Oh my God, I've scored a free kick in a fixing video. Memphis Depay puts that in. Let's go, what a free kick it was. Up and over the ball. And that should guarantee us the Champions League trophy. What a dramatic last 10, 15 minutes. And what a free kick that was from Memphis Depay. The game's done now. I think we're winning this. It's just about maybe getting another goal. Chiesa, finesse shot, easy. We're breaking the curse in style. And how could it have been incredibly different if Dybala scored his pen? We got a bit lucky. Ironic considering the title of the video. But let's go. Memphis, from distance, another one. And it is another one. Memphis Depay is honestly a bit insane. 4-0 in this Champions League final. It's done. We've just won the Champions League with the most unlucky club, probably in this competition. Enjoy the celebration, folks. Now, if you enjoyed this video, drop a like. Let me know if you guys have got any other ideas for fixing videos in the comments. Subscribe if you're new around here. And I'll catch you guys next week for another one of these. Peace.